17% of the seats are reserved for girls in each branch, in each IIT, which implies that some of the branches which have less participation from women, they will have seats added. So suppose there are 100 seats in one branch, for example, mechanical, okay, where lesser girls prefer to take mechanical, and as per the regular merit list and your preferences, only 2 girls have managed to join the top 100 seats, first 100 seats of mechanical. Now, ideally, there should have been 17 girls. So 15 seats will be added and only the girls students will be allowed to take those added 15 seats. This is supernumerary. So this is not taking any seat from the share of general candidates. However, to encourage girls, 15, couple of more seats depending on branch. For example, architecture at IIT Roorkee usually has a larger percentage of women candidates, girls. So there no seat will need to be added because in any case, more than 17% of the seats will be taken up by girl students. So it is branch specific, it is IIT specific that the seats may be added. If you are anyways in the merit, you will get what you want. You will, because you are anyways high up in the merit list. So no need to worry in case you have a very good rank. No, not at all. Every IIT has already planned for the increasing intake. We have enough resources. We have enough hostels where in the first year, usually, you get a double-seated room, which is a large room, spacious room. Maybe you can talk about that.
There's no shortage of accommodation for girls in any of the IITs. As I can talk about IIT Roorkee, girls are provided a double-seater room, which is a very spacious room in their first year and second year. After second year, they are provided with a single-seater room. So, and wherever there is a shortage, IITs have pre-planned this, that they will provide enough accommodation for all the new girls who will be admitted every year. And there are new hostels being constructed.
Lalita?
15 to 20 girls in
CSE
last year.
Okay. So, we have around 15 to 20 girls in CSE last year. That is what we know
I
of.
I was one of the instructors.
Okay. You wonder that. So, but we wouldn't know of all the IITs as such. But yes, usually there are more number of girls in CSE. Yes. Well, that absolutely depends upon your choice. We cannot guide you regarding the comparison of branches here because one, it is your choice what you want to do, and I think you should respect that. What interests you more is what you should pursue for your life. Okay? So, and along with that, if you're worried about the placements, if you're worried about the cutoffs, please go to the websites of respective IITs, and you can also visit JOSA. You can see which branches have higher cutoffs. So they are definitely the more preferred ones. So you can make a little comparison on the basis of that, but I'm sorry, we cannot help you compare branch to branch. Every branch is unique in its own manner, and it depends upon what you are more interested in.
Dual degree courses. Well, again, it goes on your preference, whichever is in your mind, whichever is you feel you'd like to follow in future, that's how you go for it. So there is no specific suggestion from us, I think, on these matters.
He's dragging still in practice.
Where is Snigdha? Snigdha, no. Ragging is absolutely banned in all the IITs. You can be very assured that we have very strict anti-ragging rules, anti-ragging laws.
And committees as well.
There are committees which monitor that no first-yearites are ragged. There are no codes. There is absolutely no ragging. In fact, at IIT Roorkee, we have also separated our first-year students, first-year boys as well as girls, from rest of the students, just to ensure that no ragging happens, no ragging takes place. So please, don't worry about ragging at all. There is no ragging. No. At no point will the qualifying marks be reduced. It will only be for the candidates who have already qualified that the remaining supernumerary seats be filled. Fortunately, you would be happy to know that we have more than enough girls students who have qualified JEE Advanced, much more than the 17% mark. So we will never fall short of the female candidates. All of the females have done really well this year. So that situation won't arise. Okay, so last year we had 14% supernumerary seats. This year we have increased it to 17%. Gradually, every year we are increasing it so that we can come up to a threshold of around 21-22%. So from last year, there is an increase of 3% seats for girls.
As soon as you get admitted, you are given the hostel the same day. So IITs are everywhere. 100% residential, has a 100% residential campus, so everyone is on the priority.
Ma'am, how to check what is the rank in girls' quota?
What is my rank in girls' quota?
There is no merit list. You cannot, we cannot tell you what is your rank in girls' quota. There is no separate merit list for girls. Yes, absolutely, yes.
Ma'am, what is the scope of aerospace in IIT Bombay?
Again, that's branch specific. I think you can visit the website of IIT Bombay and you can visit the departmental website of aerospace engineering at IIT Bombay. You would get to know all the information regarding that there only. Lalita, you answer that.
So, again, it depends upon your interest. You should pursue whatever interests you. So that will make you. So whatever interests you, you should pursue in that area only. So that will make your decision easier. It depends on your choice.
First year results.
First year results. CGPA. Yeah. That will give you a scope to apply for any other discipline, depending on the availability, depending on the vacancy on that discipline. So it does not have any otherwise list. It's just like whatever is your CGPA, and depending on that, you give your choices. And if it is available, if anybody is not a candidate who is having a better CGPA than you, then you get it.
A again, you know, we would repeat this, that please pursue what interests you. Don't go by, of course, you will have to look at the prospects, the placement potential and all that. But yet, repeatedly we say that, that please pursue what is your interest, what, you know, what is your passion. Because you, today you will, you are only choosing a branch or an institute. But actually, this is going to stay with you forever. And this is what will shape your career and your life. Okay? So please choose it according to your interest. You can get to know it from the JOSA website and the JEE website. The results, the qualifying marks, the last year's cutoff, everything is very clearly given on the JOSA and the JEE Advanced website.
Third phase, IIT, TNT, or any
Again, I think we would not suggest on the branches, and it is, please make that decision based upon the last year's cutoff and your choices. We are not comparing between branches here.
Yes.
It's absolutely online, 100%.
100%.
There were 9 girls in top 200.
But that was an overall statement.
Yeah.
And 9 girls in top 200 last year.
I have got a list of around 3,500 plus female candidates who've qualified overall.
Yeah.
So it's not the top 100 or top 200 that we're talking about. I think it's a pretty good number. It's a big number. We do not have the merit list, and that is also not the concern here for us. You can go ahead, you can check the advanced results if you can, but for us it will be difficult to talk about the results here, the merits here. No, we are not doing that here. Any other query you have, then we can look at that.
Again, whatever placement interests you.
Yeah, you're talking about placement. So I think every IIT has their placement department, and that will have a record of what kind of placement they had in the previous year and probably previous few years. So if you were specifically interested about the placement, I think the best thing will be to check the placement website of the respective IITs.
Maths and computing. I think both these are very competitive and very nice subjects. If that interests you, it's all right.
Yeah, you can go.
You can go ahead.
Ramya, can we shift from a BTech to a dual degree?
Yes, you can. If you score enough and there is availability in the branch where you want to move, then based on your CGPA in the first year, you can change the branch, provided there is availability in the branch which you are moving to. Yes, yes, that's possible.
Yeah, that's possible. Again, subject to availability of seat in that course.
First year is more general kind of subjects we have.
SVNIT placement. I think.
Yeah, you can probably check the
institute
website, placement website for that.
No.
Yeah.
No. MSc 2.
Integrated MSc.
Integrated MSc.
Yeah. As we have already mentioned, so if there is an availability in the branch that you want to go and you have enough CGPA to get the seat with respect to the others who are aspiring to change, then you can get.
Yeah, because few students. Yeah.
No, you don't have to fill any separate form. The regular merit list which is there, on the basis of that, the seat allocation will be done. No extra form or formality is needed here.
You need to consult the placement website. That will give you previous few years placement in the respective branches. In all the IITs, they have this kind of placement website in place. So you should go and check over there.
For this year, we have 17% supernumerary seats. Last year, we had 14. So we are increasing it at a rate of 3% per year till we reach the threshold. So that is what it is. And for the cutoffs, you can visit the JOSA website and go to the each branch-wise, IIT-wise cutoff. You would know it there. Sorry, can you say it again?
She's telling me what
is this. Ishika Choksi from Mumbai. My rank is 22,710. Where will I be able to get admission?
I think you can visit the JOSA website and know the last year's cutoff. That will give you a relative idea of how the same rank was placed last year. We cannot make a statement on that. We cannot give a statement on that.
I read about different branches and I liked some, but how to know what exactly should I opt for? Also, just because everyone says to go for CSE, how can we underestimate other branches?
Well, it's purely on your, choice and your willingness, your interest in doing the subject. At the same time, you can also check last year's availability of seats during in the range of your rank. So based on this too, you can opt for, so that whatever you like, you opt for them, and out of that something you get also.
There can be many factors you choose an institute, for example, geographical location. And NIRF rank, if you are talking about top 10 institutes, then I think they are very competitive and they are more or less same. You will get almost same quality in all the 10 institutes. So it should not be very difficult decision based on NIRF rank.
Actually, there are many factors that are considered when you are looking at the NIRF rank of an institute. That is not all related to only undergrad education or placement. So those are very important, keeping them in place. You need to also check for what you are exactly looking for, and you should go for placement records and other things. So that's what I think is, I won't say that NIRF ranking is, you should not consult at the same time. That should not be everything that you consider while you know, giving preference over for a branch over another or an institute over another.
I don't think there is any difference because it's the same common course which is throughout. So all the students undergo the same subjects in the first year.
First year is
common.
Yeah, towards the end only you have some extra
courses. Few subjects.
Yeah, and some maybe some project work, some research work.
Specialized subjects we have in the last years.
Yeah, that is anyway there. In many other branches, there are many students that go for non-core jobs as well. So it is, I think, more the preference of the candidate who wants to go for or not. So there is, if you want statistics on this, then you can actually check the placement as we are telling again and again, the placement website. In addition to giving the percentage of placement, they will also give the type of jobs, the companies that or the institutions that has hired them. So you can get an idea about this from there.
More seats for?
There are no seats for math in IIT for EWS candidates.
Okay, well, we are not too aware of how the seat distribution under EWS is happening, so we cannot comment on it here as of now. Again, it is your personal choice. You need to go visit the websites of all the IITs. You need to check the placements, you need to check the cutoffs of all the branches, each branch, which is of your interest, and then make a choice, an informed choice, decision. The architecture admission is on the basis of a common score which comprises of a portion of JEE Advanced and AAT. But JEE Advanced is mandatory. Once you clear that, that is when you go for the AAT exam, and on the basis of that AAT exam, a merit is prepared for admission in architecture.
It happens every year, so top students, if they want to change their branch, they can.
It happens quite regularly at IITs.
Yeah, it's every year, it's a regular practice.
See, it totally depends on the company that is coming. What all disciplines they will allow to seat for the campusing, but we have seen that it generally happens that they allow other branches for the admission. But the base thing is to check the website of placement department, you will get a list of companies that has hired for some specific department, so you will get an idea. It is purely based on the CGPA that you acquire in the after the first year, the grades that you get after the first year. Generally in first year it's a common grade with all the departments together, and then depending on your position in that rank, in that list, in the grade list, and the position that you aspire for, the department you want to go for, it is decided whether you get a chance or not.
Okay. Except architecture. If you happen to join architecture, then the, right from first year, you're separate and there is no branching possible if you are in architecture. Because we have different courses altogether.
And different channel to admit the student.
Yes, have that exam.
Yes. An extra exam.
Yes.
Tentatively, yes, but it is not absolutely final because at many a times the candidates change their preferences while finally filling up for the seats as per their choice. So it is not 100% the same, but yes, it on a large scale, yes, represents a very similar scenario of seat allocation.
In the placement allotment.
Placement allotment. We're not very sure of what do you mean by placement allotment, Ishika. But if you mean to say the percentage of students placed or things like that, well, it depends upon the companies which are coming to each IIT. So there are different companies which are going to different IITs depending upon the preferences that the companies have. So you can visit the placement websites of each IIT and you can get to know a better, you know, you can have a better idea.
Ramya, can we do a specialization in biotechnology after taking chemical engineering, or do we have to prefer biotechnology and biochemical engineering course
Yeah, I think this is possible. You have to look at the online course structures because we are now offering minors in different departments. Suppose you are in A department, you want to select courses from B department, that is possible. Then you will be called minor in B department and major in A department.
Yes. Well, as per the CGP in the first year, after the first year, you can go for that if you get, and if there is an availability in the program that you are aspiring for.
I'm sorry, we cannot do that. There is no separate merit list. It's just that we know that these many girls have qualified. That's about it. So there is no merit list and there is no ranking as such. Okay?
Which kind of engineering do to get a job in NASA or
Well, they have a very... wide background people they need it over there, starting from physicists to aerotic engineers to materials people to
mathematicians,
psychologists, and sometimes even doctors also they hire. So not even an engineer.
It's a big institution. You will be fit there if you want to.
Yes, and it is totally depends upon what is the need in a given at a given point of time. So today they may be needing more of aeronautical engineers, tomorrow they may be needing more of psychologists, the other day they may be needing more of material scientists. So it's a very, very wide range.
Shivani, what is the percentage of female faculties at IIT on an average?
Tricky question.
That's really tricky.
It depends
branch to branch.
Branch to branch, yes.
Architecture, we have a lot of faculty members, female faculty members. Chemical, we have, chemistry, mathematics, physics,
biotech.
Humanities, management.
Biotech.
I think biotech. It's branch. Now, this we are telling only about IIT Roorkee. Different IITs have different, compositions.
But the scene is improving. the male to female ratio, it is increasing. Female to male ratio.
Only MSc Biological Sciences, I don't think they are given an opportunity to change it to BTEC. If it is an integrated dual degree, in that case, you have a...
Yeah, if you are selected through JEE Advanced, then you can change within the branches. But suppose you are selected through some other, like JAM, two-year MSc program, then you cannot change to BTEC.
It depends from company to company. We really cannot comment on, and it's a very generic question, does not have a single answer also. So I don't think we are equipped enough to give a single answer to your query. Yes, it is done. And in fact, you have mandatory internships at the end of your third year. You need to go for an internship. Other than that, also the students, out of their own choice, they do several internships in the summer and winter vacations. IITs have different departments in engineering and science and even in humanities as well, and all the departments are given equal importance in our curriculum. So it's not a very specific research topic, but then of course, if we talk about research also, importance is given both in basic research as well as application-oriented research. So that's what I think we can talk about it.
Tanya, if I do a BSc, then what if I want to do a non-course?
If I do a
BSc.
But BSc's are not there in IITs, I believe. They have integrated.
BSc's in IIT?
No, we don't have.
We have only MSc's and integrated MSc's. Yes.
Integrated MSc's.
And dual degree BTEC, MTEC programs is, and BTEC of course.
There is no exit with 3
only
years.
BSc.
Only BSc.
Yeah.
Only BSc.
Shivani, could you provide an idea on what are the branches most recommended by girls and those the least recommended?
Well, I doubt we have any such statistics. And probably it's not possible also because it depends on the personal choice and interest about the subject.
And I think the whole purpose of adding these supernumerary seats in each branch is to break that stereotype that girls are preferring only one particular branch. We need more and more women in each branch, in every field. Because that is how, that's the whole purpose of this exercise that we are doing. So, in the time to come, starting from last year, I think you will see more and more number of girls in every branch. And the whole idea is to have more number of girls at this stage so that tomorrow when you go out and work in the field, industry, you get back to the academia or wherever you go, we have enough women representing every field, which in today's times is not happening. Some branches, as you have asked, are more preferred by women, some are less preferred. Tomorrow, in the time to come, we are aiming that this does not happen. You can go wherever you want and you can work wherever you want. I'm not too sure of how the seat allocation takes place. If you have got mechanical in the first round and CS in the second round, whether you will have time in between to shift and not take the one given to you in the first round and go for the one in the second round, we are not too sure of that. Probably for that, you can visit the JOSA website or you could write to Chairman JEE from any of the IITs, your doubt should get cleared.
Yeah, so you can suppose you admit in A branch and you prefer to have some courses in B branch, that is possible. You can have courses in branch B also. We also have institute electives. They are floated by different departments, so that you can also choose.
Can I say something? Yeah. Okay. In the IIT grade system, generally you have certain number of credits that you have to cover per semester. Now, in this, there will be some of the subject core courses, some of the institute core courses, some of the department electives, and some of the non-department electives. So, the institute core courses are generally from other departments, some basic courses that you are bound to take, and but the other electives, from other departments, there you can actually choose courses as per your wish from the basket that is being offered for your department. Generally, the department decide which ones could be the institute which one could be the optional electives. But all through you have a course structure. I think in many of the departments in different IITs, if you go to the department website, you will be able to see the course structure. Sometime you will be able to see the names of the courses that are offered also mentioned. The basic structure is same. Like in certain semester, if you have to take 2-3 credit courses from the department and 4-3 credit courses from institute, other departments, that structure is same. But in choosing the electives, you have the flexibility, and that's where you can have some of the courses from the other departments of your choice.
How should we choose among the branches without
knowing much about them? How can we explore the syllabus and subjects that are taught in a particular branch without entering any IIT? I think if you go and visit each of the IITs, under the departments page, you have all the departments listed. You will have to do that exercise. Go visit the website for each of the departments. Majority of the departments have their syllabuses online. They also have their placement statistics. They also have the companies who are visiting, who are recruiting the students. So all that data is available on the departmental website. You can get to know what kind of research is going on, what are the profiles of the faculty, what are fields they are working in. So I think it requires a little effort from your side so that you go visit and then make a choice.
Float and freeze options.
Well, I think you're talking about seat allocation here. The mock seat allocation, we are not too familiar about that. Maybe we can find out in meanwhile and come back to you on this, Gurusha.
Yes, yes. In many of the basic subjects you will have. In fact, you will have some overlaps as well, so that you are totally comfortable about it. But there are certain subjects which are very specific to engineering, which you have never learned before. But I'm sure after you have cleared JEE and you were here, and the level that the courses are started, it's easy to pick up for you.
We do have a group called SMP, the Student Mentorship Program, wherein senior year students, second year students, and third year students provide mentorship to first year students, wherein they meet them. There is a group of at least 10 students which is allotted to one mentor, and that student mentor will guide each student in terms of how to cope up with changes that have come up in college life, how to deal with exams and all of that. So that's how it works, if that's what you're asking.
If I speak on a branch in some IIT, then do we have
I think the JOSA website will give you more idea about it. We are not really familiar with that.
You must score some CGPA like 7.5, that I'm aware of as of now. So if your CGPA is more than a threshold, then only you can opt for minor.
That will come in third year only.
Yes.
It's not right away from the first year.
Yeah.
That comes in third year. So by then you know also like what are your interests, what are your inclinations, and which way you want to go. So you will have enough knowledge by then. First of all, there is no BSc course in IITs. It's an integrated BSc MSc. So if you are talking about that, then yes, you can do. You have to have a very good CGPA in the first year, and then you have to, there has to be a vacancy in the stream, in the discipline in which you want to get transferred. These two are the requirements. And then as per the applications, as per the number of applications, you're standing in that list, you might be getting. But this practice is exercised every year.
You will be taught from basic. Nobody expects you that you already know some part of engineering and then you are coming here. So you will be starting from basics.
Will the IIT teach us about
aeroplanes
in aerospace or about satellite space stations also?
I think the best way to check this will be you go to the IITs that aeronautics department or aerospace engineering department in their website. You will get in the academic part, academic tab, most probably you will get the course structure. Over there you will have a, you know, answer to your queries.
Are there good placements for other branches?
There are placements for every branch in IITs. It's just that the companies that they come what they want, so they will be, there'll be specific companies coming for each of the branches, and then there are other companies that will actually take from every branch. So the best thing is to check in the placement website of the IITs to know about it more.
Yes, there is an increase of 3% female seats this year.
Well, I don't think this is a fixed number. It's just depending on how many vacancies were there initially, or there are some vacancies created in between. So it's really not, I don't think there's any database that will be having a single way answer for your question.
It changes from year to year.
Absolutely, supernumerary seat addition and allocation is totally a computer-based, program-based, you know, allocation. So you just have to fill out your branches carefully, fill up, and then you can leave it at that. Is Gurusha still there? I think I can see Gurusha's name. Gurusha, I found out about the float and freeze option. So if you freeze, whatever option you have given will be frozen and you are out of the counseling session. So you cannot change your preferences anymore. Whatever you have opted for, if you get that, you will be given, else not. The second is the float option. In the float option, you can fill out as many as you want, and then depending upon your choice and your rank, you will be given a branch, but later on, if there is an availability of seat in a branch which was earlier unavailable at your rank, then also you can float to it. It is between IITs, institutes and branches. There is a third option also, which is of slide. So here the institute is fixed, but you can slide horizontally between the branches at a later stage also. So if there is an availability of the seat, you may still get it, but within the same institute. So these are the three options, and that is what they mean. There are different types of sessions. IIT Roorkee has taken the initiative of hosting an online open house. IITs which are in bigger cities and have proximity for majority of the candidates, for example Delhi and Bombay, they have hosted physical open house sessions where you can go personally, talk to the mentors, talk to the nodal officers. So they have that possibility as well. Other than that, you can mail at the women help desk. Every IIT has a women help desk created. So you can mail your queries and you can get answers to that.
So by float or slide, we can go in both directions, up and down in our preference of streets.
Yes. So preferably allowing you to go up. Yes.
Up, down,
it's only up that you want to go. There is no cutoff going up or down. It is just that the seats will be filled for at least 17% of the girls in each branch at whatever rank it happens. So there is no lowering of the standard as such. No, it's not happening. If you have any query, please write because all your audios are muted.
What are the opportunities for non-core jobs if I take biotech?
Well, it's very difficult to tell directly about it. The best thing is you check the placement website or the biotech department website of the respective IITs to get a list of companies that they hire. So from there you can get an idea.
I told you earlier also it's 17% of the total seats per branch per IIT.
Minimum is 17%.
ऐसा होता नहीं होगा शायद.
What is the seat matrix for a branch engineering?
How many seats are there in
aerospace?
Sorry.
What is the seat matrix
seat metrics for the branch in general. I think you want to know the percentage of boys versus girls, that is what you want to know. Well, we cannot give a very definitive answer to that, because one is that it is changing. At least in the last year, we can say that 14% was ensured in each branch, in each of the IIT. At least that much was done, yes. Admission at any good IIT? Well, we just do not guarantee that. If you qualify IIT, enter the system and don't perform, nobody can guarantee your placement. So you have to enter the IIT system and you have to continuously perform at any stage if you want to ensure a good placement, a good career for yourself. The career path is just beginning. It's the beginning of your career. Okay.
How many seats are there in aerospace engineering for PG candidates?
Minimum 17.
Whatever the number of total seats are, 17% of that is for female candidates in any branch, in any IIT.
I am interested in math and computers. So what are the options other than CSC and mathematics?
I think these are the best options. If you are interested in computers, then you should look either of the two branches you are mentioning.
There are indicated 5-year courses for B.Tech plus M.Tech. Are these provided by two IITs or
these are there in most of the IITs, but in not all of the departments. It depends on the distribution of the IITs, in which branches they will give, whether they will give or not. So you will see that it is not available over all the IITs and over all the departments.
You have to make up your mind and your choice. That is perfectly your decision.
Absolutely. Yeah, actually in integrated course you get a dual degree, you get a PG degree. So if it depends what you want to do after getting the degree. Sometimes people who are oriented to go for higher studies or research, sometimes, not always of course, they prefer to get a PG degree. So it's totally up to you. There is. There is absolutely no one answer or no pattern regarding this. We have many a time seen. I can tell you about my department where the typical percentage of girls are. Well, I am from metallurgical and materials engineering over here in IIT Roorkee. Typically, 4 to 5% girls, and many a time the girls top the class. There's no, absolutely no pattern. It just depends how seriously you take it and how you study, whatever is the branch, whatever are the things, that there's no restriction about the capability of girls as such. So I think
To succeed in any branch, in any IIT, you need to be diligent. You need to stay focused towards the studies or whatever cause. Tomorrow, when you come at IIT, you may decide that I'm not too focused, I don't want to get very good grades, but you're focused on something else. Well, you may do that as well. Nobody stops you, because now you are absolutely on your own. You are grown-up adults. You have to make your own choice. But the bottom line is, you have to be hardworking and diligent. If you are, then nobody stops you from succeeding. I think you visit JOSA seat and look at how the seats got filled up last year and then check for your available branches and then make a choice, an informed decision. It is different for each branch and each IIT. It totally depends upon, the department. So visit the departments, look at the seat structure, look at the total number.
What is the best option for AIR 11,901?
Again, my suggestion, and we are not the best people to help you out with the branch selection. You have to do it on your own based upon your choice and also last year's seat allocation. All the new IITs are coming up in a very good manner. They are very well supported by the government. Very good faculty is being hired and infrastructure is being developed. So you can visit the websites of these new IITs to know more about each one of them. And good progress is being made. So they are coming up really good. I think you can visit the departmental websites in each of the IITs that you have mentioned, and you can get to know the syllabus for each of these branches. That will help you make up your mind in a better manner. Oh, okay.
Reads it, we can maybe repeat it once.
Okay.
Or I think we
name. I think name would.
Yeah, I think I will repeat the name of the person and the question to which the answer is being given.
Rajdarshi, if we haven't got our favorite branch in IIT, can we change our branch next year? If yes, what is the reason?
Okay, Rajlakshmi, the procedure is that after the first year, you will have to have a very good grade. We call it CGPA over here.
CGPA
over here after first year. That is the first criteria. The second criteria is that the branch that you want to change to should have a vacancy. Then depending on that, you have to make an application. And in that application, say others are also applying, whatever is your position, depending on that and depending on availability, you will be given the chance to change your branch. This procedure is practiced every year after first year results are out. And then you get a chance.
Any chances for admission into IIT with AIR 10,001?
Please, what's the name? Gyandipta. Gyandipta, go to JOSA website and check what has been the cutoff last year. I think you would get to know in a much better manner.
Dhwani, again it depends upon two things, like Professor Debrupa said. It depends upon your CGPA in first year and the availability in the branch where you want to move.
But if your question was if you are taking earth sciences, admission in earth sciences, that's BTech. Yes, you are common. Like no. Any other BTech, and you are eligible for a branch change if you get a good CGPA.
Even for dual degree also.
Yeah, even for dual degree. Yeah.
What is the backside of each branch at IIT?
It varies from branch to branch. Like electrical engineering has 150 intake per year.
Architecture has only 30.
Yes.
So it changes from batch to branch to branch. JOSA will always show the opening and closing rank of the previous year. This year's will come out once you have all opted. So it will be available for the 2020 candidates, but not for you. Dhwani, go to JOSA website, please. I think you will get to know best there. I think in JOSA, it is showing what was the cutoff for female category and for gender neutral, which was the regular merit list. You will get to know what was the cutoff for female candidates in each specific branch.
You have to give exams, like if you want to go for M.Tech, you have to appear in GATE. If you want to go for MSc's, you have to prepare for JAM. MBA, you have to qualify CAT and so on. So you have to again perform.
If you take admission in a dual degree, well, then you come out with an M.Tech, B.Tech plus M.Tech together.
Whole class together doesn't study so much like we do.
Sorry?
Whole class together doesn't study too much like we do for delivering one lecture. That's right. Every time we are studying.
Maybe Madam, you can replace Srishti. She's been there for a while. She must be tired.
इसका क्या है जो ये काउंसलिंग है तो व्हाट इज द मैंडेट ऑफ दिस काउंसलिंग क्या पर्पस क्या है
पर्पस इज टू हेल्प द गर्ल्स कैंडिडेट फीमेल कैंडिडेट्स
used to call, na? I used to see a lot of questions about sometimes their fathers also will come and tell me, I'm going to go there, how will it be?
That is why I, along with Professor Ramesh Sharma, decided that we are having an open house. Because answering the queries on phone is quite a time question and very distracting.
Like we are telling one answer to then 20 people can.
same thing
yes. Still we are repeating
and there will be and this is better actually because there will have those typical kind of nagging questions also wahan pe jayega paisa ye hua ye bank kuch to idea hoga bata kisi ko so these are mostly general questions than girl specific questions this time they're asking
that is what I was saying
except that it's super
every majority of the questions we've been asked, like answering based upon the supernumerary seat allocation. That is what the major worry is.
Mm-hmm. And also, I don't know if you had, last time we had to think like, sometimes the boys also will call because the number is
yeah,
it is to happen, right? It's also
deliberately did not put up anybody's mobile number. I realized that it was a big mistake last year.
It is not good also.
Yeah. You know, they will call and the boys also will call, and of course you cannot be too rude, you know, to them that, oh, I hear yourself. I don't know if it's
Can we mute it if we do not have a question from the candidates? Once we have, then we can unmute it. No, this one, that's for the group chat. No, don't do that.
Switch.
Yeah.
Okay, I think this one, yeah.
No, that's unmute.
That's unmute? No, that is already...
Deepak, can we mute our mic? For the time being, there are no queries as of now.
Shall we do it in the second?
Prasidha, only IITs do not take through IIT JEE.
Yes.
There are many other colleges who are selecting their students through the JEE exam. So that is why, and it is not necessary that all those who have qualified IIT JEE will come to join IITs. There are many students who are giving exams, writing exams for MBBS like AIIMS and all other. So pre-medical entrance exams are also being taken up by the same set of students. So many students, they go on to join medical. That's why. Mechanical is a wonderful branch. It is a wonderful department at present, because last year we had this 14% supernumerary. So they already have 14% girls in the batch prior to you. Your immediate senior batch would have at least 14% girls. So mechanical is a good branch, and you can absolutely come and join. It is a very well equipped and a beautiful department at IIT Roorkee.
That is very much in place in IIT Roorkee. In fact, the scopes are wonderful. We have seen many students that take research-related projects with other departments. And it's up to your choice. I mean, if you want to work more, if you want to get more involved, you are always welcome by the professors in different departments to work on other projects, and there is no bar about it.
Please go and visit the respective department's website to know what the differences are. I think they better explain that. We have our limited domains. Abhishna.
Yes, it is possible. Based on your CGPA in first year and availability in the branch you want to move, it is possible.
If you look at JOSA website, the cutoff for the last year is on the basis of the rank. So you definitely know what is your rank, and there you can make a decision, an informed decision. Though it will never be an absolute one, the last year's branch allocation, the seat cutoff is not what is exactly going to be followed this year. There is a changing shift, focus, preference. So, but yes, tentatively you can know from there, the branch-wise cutoff.
I doubt that they have attached washrooms, but as far as IIT Mandi and Roper are concerned, we are not very much aware of their hostel facilities.
Mandi has very good hostels, I got to know. Okay. But Mandi has now, okay, like these are new IITs, so new infrastructure is being developed, and in fact very good infrastructure is being developed currently. So I think if you are going to go to any of the IITs, you do not have to worry about the accommodation facilities, because in each IIT we pay a lot of attention and emphasis on providing very good accommodation and food to our students. So I think accommodation is reasonably good, though I doubt that whether attached washrooms are there, but you don't find any problem.
Actually even none of the old IITs also, I believe, they have attached washrooms. But the proportion, like number of washrooms with respect to the number of students per washroom, is pretty decent.
Yes.
So.
And they're very well maintained. I think our student scholars who are here can tell you more about how we are maintaining at IIT Roorkee.
The hostels and the washrooms are very well maintained. There are there is good housekeeping staff. They clean it every day. The number of washrooms and toilets per floor is actually more than the required number. So I don't think there will be a problem whatsoever if you are staying in the hostel.
Within the same IIT,
yeah. Ramya, you can change branch within the same IIT. You cannot change the institute. It's branch change, not institute change.
What is the concept of minority after Bollywood?
Okay, Rupal, if you acquire certain minimum threshold of CGPA, then you are eligible to opt for courses in some other department. That is the that is called the minor in other department. So you can check on the website in the course structure what courses a department offers as minor courses. That can be checked on the website.
Rashish, if I take my BTech from an IIT and want to pursue an
Yes, you have to. This is for
Rajlakshmi.
Yes, you have to appear in gate exam.
I don't think there is any separate rank list for girls. It's the same rank list. सेकेंड ऑप्शन के बाद भी फ्लोट रख सकते हैं कि तभी चॉइस करना पड़ेगा कोई आइडिया है
वो ऑटोमेटिकली मूव करता है
नहीं फ्लोट को
व्हिच क्वेश्चन हु तनाया तनाया इफ वी गेट
सीट एलोकेटेड इन सेकेंड राउंड एंड इट इज नॉट एज पर आवर प्रेफर्ड चॉइस शुड वी गो फॉर द फ्लोट ऑप्शन और वी हैव टू टेक एडमिशन मींस फ्रीज करना है तभी कि फिर फ्लोट ही रख सकते हो ऐसा
I think you the float implies that till the final admissions are done, you still have your float choice open, and you can be shifting to the from seat to seat. I think more information on this can be found if you directly write to the chairman JEE. So they are very clear about the admission procedure and how the seat allocation has to be done. Mechanical seems to be quite a hot choice discussion here. Well, 14% last year, and prior to that, we are not too sure. But last year, definitely there were 14%.
Prior to that, we always had 3 to 5 students in mechanical.
अच्छा 14% देने के लिए आए नहीं है
अभी नहीं है
अच्छा
3 टू 5 पिछले उसके पहले था सुपर न्यूमरी के पहले होता
था
हां लेकिन लास्ट ईयर सुपर न्यूमरी था तो देन प्रोबब्ली
तब इंक्रीज हुआ
14 ऐड किया ना
14 नहीं हुआ नहीं लास्ट ईयर या देयर वर अबाउट 10 अप टू 10 स्टूडेंट्स वर देयर इन मैकेनिकल
Well, Rajalakshmi, there is no separate merit list for girls, so a comparison cannot be made as such. No, there is no girls quota for recruitment. You have to perform. Once you come here and after that it's open. Who is answering your questions? Rupal, you joined late. We are faculty members who are working in different departments at IIT. We also have student volunteers who are staying on campus for past couple of years. Mike is disabled.
Yes,
Rupal, your mic is disabled to speak because there are many participants and we cannot handle audio queries from everyone. If you have a query, please write in the chat box. I think exact number I cannot tell, but it is 17% in each branch is what is available for girls to get admitted. Srishti, you want to tell how is the hostel facility?
Maybe you can come here.
The hostel is a good place for starters. For the first year, you will be given a double-seater room. And in the third year, you will be given a single-seater room. You have common toilets per floor. Along with that, you have facilities like gym and a small reading pace and the mess. If there is any other query, you can ask.
Well, every department has a very good prospect, but we are not sure in which way you were talking about. In case you are talking about the teaching that you get here, you should consult the department website. In case you are talking about the placement, you should check the placement website. There you will get the data. Anyways, yeah, I think there is no bar about the eligibility.
I think there are a number of attempts
there
which
are
fixed.
Attempts.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. But so that is not connected to whether you have joined an IIT and
yeah,
then
that's not
there's
connected.
Nothing like that.
I think.
Okay. No, but that automatically khatam ho gaya na. See, school mein
do attempts hai na.
Do attempt hai ek school mein diya. अच्छा स्कूल वाले में ही
अगर ये हो गया तो सॉरी कैन यू रिपीट नो इट इज ब्रांच वाइज एंड इट इज 17% दिस ईयर स्तुति इट्स नॉट 14% सो इट इज 17% एंड पर ब्रांच पर आईआईटी सो एवरी ब्रांच विल हैव 17% सीट्स दैट्स व्हाट इट इंप्लाइज
You will have to acquire a number of let's say X number of credits to fulfill your requirement for BTech degree. Those credits can be met through minor courses as well as major courses. So it's not that you have to do two separate studies or it will not be a kind of double load. So you will have to pass certain number of courses or credit requirement that you have to do. No, on your degree it will be mentioned that you are in X department BTech or MTech, whatever, with minor in Y department.
This is which?
Astha.
I will check about that and maybe we can come back to you on this question a little later. Percentage wise, I can tell that from previous years 14%, it has been increased to 17%, but absolute number I'm not too sure of.
I think we have to look for it and then come back to you. I think it's best that you visit the website of those IITs. They have either a student activities department website or other kind of international relation website which will give you an idea about each of these programs, their requirements and their intakes and all. I think the best idea you will get from the JOSA website from the previous year's availabilities. Total number of seats. That we have to check.
We have to check. We'll get back to you.
Does the JEE advanced rank of 15,776, which branch should I get from Bursley?
well, there is no direct answer that we have from for this one. You should contact the JOSA website. Oh, okay, sure. This is to Khushi. Achha, they are not able to listen to you, right?
Yes.
Huh?
Yeah, maybe. So,
वो वाला माइक भी ऑन हो सकता है क्या? उसको ऑन मतलब वहाँ पे भी ऑन हो सकता है?
उसको ऑन करेंगे तो वहाँ पे जाएगा? उनको सुनाई देगा? तो वो भी ऑन कर दीजिए फिर.
I think we need to remember this question, sir. One was that how many seats has got increased, and what was the other question before that?
EWS can be.
हाँ, EWS कैटेगरी में क्या था, कितना सीट, हाँ, कितना सीट ऐड हुआ है,
इंक्रीज
EWS इकोनॉमी करी भी प्लस 100 ऐड हुआ है, तो इसी इसी के लिए इसी का पर्पस वही था. स्पोर्ट्स कोटा कितना कोटा
अब लोग कितने
विल ड्यूअल डिग्री इज द वन इन विच ऑफ कोर्स यू नो दैट यू गेट अ पीजी डिग्री यू गेट अ मास्टर्स डिग्री बेसिकली ऑल टुगेदर सो इट्स नॉट मोर हेक्टिक बिकॉज फॉर द कॉमन ईयर्स विद BTech degree, you have similar course weightage, and then you have an extra year typically to do the extra courses and some part of a research work, a project. So the weightage is spread all over, so it's not more hectic. And as it goes for the part of your question which says what is that, that it is, if it is worth doing it, well, of course it's up to your choice. With 1 year extra, you get a master's degree, and of course, when you take this course, you have in your mind what you want to do in future. So that way, the worthiness is to your plans, future plans. So I think that's it.
Yes, we have a number of cultural activities, Akanksha. Like we have cinema club. I think students can answer in a better way.
We have lots of activities. We have a cultural fest every year that is conducted. Other than that, we have lots of clubs in the entire through the year. Whatever you are interested in, you can join the club, and you can be a part of the organizing committee, as well as you can be participant during any of the event that is happening through the academic year.
Yeah, so we have, I think, we have cultural section, cultural group, which has
music,
dance, choreography. You have literary, you have I think cinematography, light and sound. A lot of these sections are there, apart
from
astronomy. So, other than that, there is a hobbies kind of group where you have fine arts, you have gardening, you have astronomy, you have photography, you have robotics. So students, so suppose you are in one particular branch and you are interested in robotics, it's not necessary that you will go to take up courses from other branches which have subjects related to robotics. You can also pursue it as a hobby and learn by the way of doing through your peers, through your friends, seniors, and mentors.
Acha, before we go to the next question, some of you had queries regarding the total number of seats that has got increased or how many you have in EWS. We really don't have that kind of database to take up your questions. Maybe you can consult the JOSA website.
JOSA website, or you could write to Chairman JEE if you have a query on that. No. IIT admissions are not through any quota. There is only admission through JEE. That's it.
I think the provision is to take minors from one department only, but you can take institute electives from other departments.
The mess food is really good. Every week a special menu is designed, so we get good and nutritious food. Breakfast, there is an elaborate menu of choices that you can pick from. For lunch, again, every day the menu changes, and it is ensured that students are getting good nutritious food throughout the week. Even during the vacations, the mess is running for students who are here for internships and for project. So if you have suggestions or any complaints regarding the mess food, there is a person in charge, the mess secretary, who can be contacted, and this can be, suggestions are always welcome.
I think very proudly, all of us can tell you that IIT Roorkee won the best food provider category award from Ministry of Health this year. So our messes, our hostel messes, were evaluated, assessed to provide the best food in the country from any of the messes. So you can look for that news clipping as well. And we at IIT Roorkee take special care, and students only make their own menu. So every year, every week, the group of students change, and you can set your own menu. So that's what it is. Well, I told you earlier also, they're coming up really good. The infrastructure is being developed fast and in a very organized and proper manner. No, at IIT Roorkee, we are not planning for any physical open house. This is the open house that we are hosting, and we can still take in your queries through the common mail ID, jeew.helpdesk, which has been provided on the website as well.
I think you should better consult the website of the Aerospace Engineering Department in different IITs. That will give you a better idea. Yeah. Aditi, I don't think there is a difference, because the faculty members are recruited in all the IITs with their credentials being in of that level. So the teaching quality should be at par in all the IITs. AK, I don't think that is possible, because major is an engrossed criteria of having your grade points covered. So with that, I don't think anybody can pursue a double major. Stuti, yes, there is a female faculty in the mechanical department at IIT Roorkee. You can check in the website her mention, and her website page, her page will be there.
Some of the newer IITs are mentored by older IITs. Do the older IIT professors teach their old time, or
Prashida, the newer IITs, they have their own professors for regular teaching. The professors from older IITs might go for some special courses, or sometimes they are deputed to take some courses over newer IITs, mentorship. No, sometimes the professors are deputed also in the newer IITs for taking the courses. But each of the new IITs, they have their own faculty strength.
Akanksha, what specifically do you want to know about TechFest? Please make your question a little specific.
How many girls qualified from general tech?
How many girls candidates? Well, we don't have that data. I think category-wise data we don't have.
Khushbu, we are not sure if we are aware of any such recommendation.
All the courses are good and they are equally recommended. That's
yes,
a clear message from our side.
Asta, is there any minority quota for gents?
No, IITs do not have, I've earlier also mentioned, there are no quotas for anybody in IITs. That's as per the government rules.
Yeah. But did he not switch on your mic? Okay, fine.
Okay, Asta, you are asking, is there any minority quota for gents? The only reservations or quotas which are applicable in IITs are those as
decided
by the government and MHRD. So there are no specific quotas in different IITs other than those governed by the central government. There are mentors, and the faculty mentors help the students to arrange the visits and lectures from experts in the fields. So it's not that the students learn on their own all the time. There are experts who are called. However, the large part of the learning is through peer group learning. It is not through what the experts teach you.
Shivani, the institute electives are generally the electives that are float by different departments. So it's specific to the department, whatever all electives they wish to float. Generally, these electives are taken by the students from other departments, not of the same department. And that are kind of open, but sometimes the parent department to which the student belong might have a basket from which you have to choose the institute electives. So this is mostly to give you a flavor of different other areas of study which you think can be useful to your area. It's like a complementary kind of area that you would like to explore.
I think, Mrunali, you can type in there that they should turn on their audio and put it on a high volume because their audio is muted, but our audio is on. So in case they have turned off our audio, they have turned down the volume, they can correct it.
Achha, what? Will it be necessary for the students to take really extra classes after admission, or will the teachers be always available to help queries from the students? Akanksha, the professors are generally available for taking care of the queries from the students even beyond the class hours. The students are, they can come anytime, meet the professors in their respective offices and can get their queries cleared. In some cases, we do have senior postgraduate students also assisting in the some parts of teaching. They are also available most of the time. Other than this, you have tutorial classes in most of the courses. And these are the provisions for having a detailed interaction for understanding the subjects well.
Okay, so TechFest is an event where students from many other colleges come together. Along with that, we have some very good speakers, experts who are invited and who talk. There are people from the industry, companies who talk about the relevant fields, relevant issues. And this way, you get a bigger exposure. And you get to work on some specific problems also, and you get a feedback of the jury members and the experts on your work. This is how TechFest will help you. Yes, every year there are some mock JOSA rounds, and if you visit the JOSA, you will see that there are mock selections, mock seat allocations which are being done. I think there are 2 to 3 rounds of mock, after which the finalization will be done.
Akansha, yes, the students can go, and in fact there are many students that go to other colleges for summer schools, for the summer interns specifically.
What is the 10% upgradation? 10% upgradation, I don't know where did you get to hear about the 10% upgradation. There is a branch change which is a sort of upgradation if you call that. But there is no 10% upgradation as such.
Akansha, yes, there are exchange students, and many of our students also go to other universities, and especially the universities in other countries for some exchange program. That has to be university, that has to be institute approved, and the academic things, by which I mean the number of grades to be completed and on, has to be taken care and agreed upon, and then the students go for typically up to one semester.
Yes. So there are a couple of exchange programs which are already there, like DAAD is there, where the student exchange between Germany and India is happening. There are other programs where students are going to Switzerland and many other countries. So there are already MOUs in place which help students to undergo such exchange programs. But unfailingly, all these programs require students to perform well, and there will always be a very high CGPA cutoff criteria. So only the ones who are performing good are eligible for such exchange programs.
Yes. Yeah, IITs are generally residential campuses, so all the students that get admission get a hostel facility.
Janvi, how is electrical engineering in
new IITs like 1 year ago? Janvi and all others who are seeking answers or support which is about a particular specific branch, we are sorry, we do not have that information. If you have general queries, then we can answer them. For specific branch-wise information, you can go to the departmental websites in each of the IIT and know more about them. Khushbu, if there are students who want to stay outside campus, they can. But staying on campus is always preferred by students only, because there are many more facilities which you don't get outside the campus. So campus is more equipped
with facilities like uninterrupted internet and power supply and water supply, library access, departmental access, and so on.
Mess,
so,
security.
Mess, yeah, security, yes, and food, everything. So I'm sure once you come here, you would prefer to stay on campus only, but there is no limitation. If a student wants to stay outside campus and not avail the hostel and mess facilities, he or she can.
We cannot really comment on this, so it's up to your choice. Well, I am not aware about all the other IITs, but definitely in IIT Roorkee, there is nothing like that. As per the requirement, the student can go in and out, but of course there are some kind of login system, right? When you go out
after
11, you have to register.
Yeah.
You have register.
But that is mainly because of security concerns.
Yes.
Not otherwise.
Astha, can you, I would recommend that you visit the departmental website of each IIT and look at the career prospects based upon the placements that have happened in the past few years. So me, I'm not too sure of how the allocation of seats is happening. I think you should visit the JOSA website. They have detailed it out in on JOSA website, and it is quite clear there. Else, you could write to Chairman JEE for clarifying.
I don't prefer during counseling. Study courses.
Some other branches.
Well, you have to Gauri Rajaram. You have to, if you have accepted admission in certain department, you have to do majorly the courses from that same department, and you get a degree also from the same department. But there are certain options like the minor option, which you get after third year, where you can choose any other department as your minor department, and with a set of course that is fixed by that department you have to take, and you get a minor specialization in that department. Other than that, there are certain kind of institute electives that are offered throughout the 4 years of your program, 4 or 5 years of your program, which you can take as a flavor of that department, some of the courses. Again, these courses are not any course that you choose. This has to be floated as institute elective by those departments and has to be accepted by your major department. But your degree anyway comes with your major department only. Yes, Tuti, I think we have just responded to this in detail in a couple of minutes back. So yes, you have student exchange programs that have been acknowledged by IIT Roorkee, and there is a sale that and certain such programs are in place, and every year we have our students going for such exchange programs.
Okay, Ramya, you have to acquire certain CGPA, number one, and number two, you must have some vacancy in the branch where you want to move. So based on your first year CGPA, this can be possible. In that round, Asta, you are tentatively allotted the seat.
Anshul, I think these things are quite nicely detailed in the JOSA website. Yes, you should be referring to that. Khushbu, as per our knowledge, yes, there are core biotech placements that are happening in IIT Roorkee as in other IITs, but the best way to check is to visit the placement website of IIT Roorkee, and there department wise you will get the list of the companies and the percentage placements. Neha, the best thing would be to check the biotech website and also the placement department for this kind of information.
Nandini, yes. Every program has certain amount of coding included, so you get to learn. And you can also choose some CSE department courses,
elective courses as minor,
so that is possible. No, only after first year, Archer.
Somi, the best thing would be to check with the JOSA website about this. They have the details. Aditi, as I understand, in the float option, you have your choices live. That means you have not frozen them. So you can actually go for other institute and other branches that are available, whereas in slide option you actually have frozen your institute. So in the same institute you can actually go for another branch as per availability, of course. Stuti, to answer your question, yes, from first year onwards you can take research projects in different departments under the mentorship of different professors, including your own department. In the fourth year, generally you have a BTEC project for 1 year, and that is a research project that is a mandatory one. As of now, that is in IIT Roorkee, that is a mandatory one. Some other IITs has made it an optional, but there, of course, you have to go for a research project.
Yeah, the entire campus Akanksha is Wi-Fi enabled. In hostels, you have wired connection also, apart from Wi-Fi connection. So you have internet speed in a very good condition.
Akanksha, I'd like to just add one thing over here. Here we are actually talking about IIT Roorkee. Yeah. So different IIT has their own kind of...
Yes, there is a provision of getting married accommodation where you are provided with a kitchen and you can cook your own food or arrange for a maid who can cook for you, or you can any of your family member can stay with you who can help you in your cooking or getting food.
In the mess also you get special food.
Yeah, in the mess also there is a provision for getting a special Sikh diet. You can opt for that if you cannot have the regular diet due to any of the health issues.
Janvi, to answer your question, ragging is taken very seriously in all over the IIT system. There are different processes and committees in place. So there is no ragging. And even if it is there is always... portals and committees to report for, and the actions are taken pretty quickly. So there's no fear from ragging as of now in IIT system.
Dr. Shri,
Rajalakshmi, to answer your question, yes. Many of our students, first year onwards, on their own interest, they take research projects in their major department as well as in other department with the mentorship of the professors. And when the professor agrees to mentor the student, of course, they provide all the supports and facilities.
Okay, so in engineering physics, you study in the first year, it is common like for any other engineering. From second year onwards, you study courses like microprocessor, systems and designing. So you are given a flavor more like electrical and electronics engineering. So that's a pretty good discipline, and our students are doing very well. You can get more information from the website. Course structure and syllabi are given there.
Well, Janabi, I can just tell you that many of our students go to abroad for higher degrees, masters and PhD. If it is of your help. Neha, the best way to know about it is to look into the website of the biotech departments in different IITs and also their placement website for the relevant information. Stuti, I am not sure what exactly do you expect from your visit. Well, as a visitor, you can come to IIT Roorkee, but officially I do not know if any kind of, call that?
Accommodation, fooding, lodging we can provide. We are not sure about that. We cannot promise on that.
Yeah.
You can certainly come and see the place. But we cannot promise any other facility for your visit.
And the orientation program is also for after admission, after taking admission.
Manish, I want to know if my daughter who has the rank of 22,800 in
JA Advanced
will get admission
at IIT. Mr. Manish, we are not really able to give you this kind of information at this forum. Shibani, we need to look into it in more detail and then we can come back to you.
Yes, it depends upon your CGPA. What's his name?
Gauri Rajaraman.
Gauri Rajaraman. It will depend upon your CGPA.
Rupal, no, you don't get 2 degrees, you just get only 1 BTEC degree, but in your certificate it will be written that you have done your major in the main department that you have joined and you have done a minor specialization in the other department where you take the prescribed number of electives, number of courses I would say rather.
Yes.
Neha, I'm not sure which project you're talking about. If you're talking about the required BTEC project, then I believe it depends from department to department, depending on their procedure, their rules, it is decided. If it will be individual, if it is in group, and how many groups of how many students.
Thank you.
about the degrees that are being offered in different IITs, I'm sure you get the information from JOSA website as well as in the individual IITs website as well. There is no interdisciplinary degree as such, but of course you can have a major degree in one of the disciplines and a minor in another. But typically the departments are the kind of traditional ones in all the IITs. Not like mechatronics and stuff.
Ramya, what is the scope of placements in newly established IITs? What are the colleges except very advanced
school? For Ramya, for your second part of the question, what are the colleges? I think from JOSA website you can get an idea about it, or you have to look into it. For the first part, whether this is scope of placement, you should actually visit the placement website of the respective IITs to know more about it.
How many days before the admission process for the class will be over, and what is the date of session start?
You must be having, Khushbu, a date list of important dates of admission procedure, and we start our session around 16th to 20th July at IIT Roorkee. So you may now get the idea how much time you will get between counseling and joining the session here.
We had a question left na in between. So if we can go back. There was a question left that we told we'll come back later.
Yeah,
maybe
how many rounds of counseling we'll get final
super,
allocation of the seat. There was
super
a question.
Memory before that, how many rounds will be done?
I think even I'm not too sure of that. Supernumerary is done only after all the seat allocations have been done.
So, okay, so whatever number of rounds.
Maybe after the second round, yes.
But first round, they will see how many girls are there in the
yes.
per branch.
Per branch.
And then they will add up, top up, whatever they want to do.
After the second round of counseling is
over.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, in IIT Roorkee, Akansha, yes, it is.
No, it is, I don't think.
No. Okay,
it
okay.
is during the exams that it is open 24/7, but other times only the reading room is open. You can go to the library, but you can't get the books issued. So you can go in the library, yes, that way it is 24/7, but you can't get the books issued or take out of the stacks.
But
reading
in the reading
room
section,
is there.
Yeah, reading room you can...
Bring
but,
your own books
okay.
and copies.
It's not about
notes,
the period. No,
etc. You can
okay.
bring.
Okay.
So,
is Roorkee and the city safe for girls?
I think I definitely needed to answer this. Roorkee is a very safe city for girls. Often we have this misconception, and we have female candidates, girls candidates asking us this question because of the belt we are in, which is often in news for wrong reasons, but Roorkee is a very safe place. Especially IIT Roorkee is a very safe campus. It is on security, heavy security all the time, 24/7, and that is why girls are allowed to roam within the campus 24/7. You would hear very few crimes happening in the city, even outside, as compared to the bigger cities like Delhi or Bombay. Roorkee is much, much safer. We haven't in our stay, and I am a product of IIT Roorkee only. I have stayed here for a very long duration. I have never seen any very grave crime happening in the city outside. I think Lalita would agree with me on that.
I
both of us have
agree.
Stayed for a reasonably long duration here.
I can and dare to come at any time in night from railway station to my campus, so it's a very safe city.
It is a safe city. So be very assured that IIT Roorkee is your choice, not just the campus, but city itself is reasonably safe.
Is branch change for 4-year
course possible by 3 to 5 years? Yes, it is possible. Rishija.
Rishija.
It is possible to change 4-year program to 5-year or vice versa based on your CGPA in first year and availability in the department you are moving. Yes, Akanksha,
Falguni.
Sorry. It is possible to conduct your work in national laboratories. It is very much possible.
Yes, I think that is very much encouraged. Every branch takes their students on education tours, which are supported infrastructurally as well as financially, partially from the institute side. At IIT Roorkee, there are no restrictions for girls as far as your hostels are concerned. I think in general, IITs, because they are developed as a full-fledged entire campus, they ensure that there is a good security that prevails on the campus. So all the IITs are reasonably safe for that matter. As far as the in-time and the hostel timings and others are concerned, maybe you can visit the institute's website and you can have an idea whether what are the in and out timings for girls. Mm-hmm. At IIT Roorkee, it is 24/7. No, there is no dress code for anybody, any student in classroom or the hostels. Yet at the same time, because you are going to become professionals after you pass out from IITs, you are expected to develop a decent way of dressing. That's about it. But it is not a mandate. There is no dress code as such.
Separate rank list?
Yeah, Vishakha, there is no separate rank list for girls, merit list for girls. What's the question?
Yes, yeah, to take up your question, there is in IIT Roorkee, there is a incubation center by DST called Tides. They help the students in setting up their own startups. And there are other IITs in where also they have similar kind of facilities by the DST, by the MHRD, that help students in incubating their startups for a certain period of time with some kind of facilities made available.
But you have to undergo a proper screening process.
Yes.
So you have to have a very robust business idea proposal, which will be scrutinized, which will be evaluated by your team. And once you, you know, clear that evaluation, that is when you will be funded. And that is when you will be allowed to start.
Sorry? Coding culture. Yes, it is very good at IITR. In fact, we have in computer center one dedicated one dedicated department for students. What we call it? IMG group. The IMG group is there, which helps in maintaining the institute websites and upgradation. So it's the IIT Roorkee has very good culture of coding. Yeah. Our students are very good.
I think very recently IIT students won a very prestigious competition, student competition, which was mainly involved which mainly involves students to code. So programming and coding is
and that was one international event.
I think one international event where Professor Bala along with his students won.
Yes.
Correct.
If you want to know, I think you can write to Chairman JEE or the JEE Women Helpline through mail. So that statistics may be shared if the JEE has prepared that list. Okay, so Khushbu, the supernumerary seats are filled up by ensuring that there is a 17% there are 17% girls in each branch in each IIT. So suppose there are 100 students, so 100 seats in a branch, and as per the merit only 5 girl students come, while as per the supernumerary, 17% girls should have been admitted, that makes it 17. So once the counseling is over and we have finalized that there are only 4-5 girls, the remaining seats out of the 17 will be added to the branch where only the girls will be given admission, irrespective of their rank. The only qualifier being they should have qualified the JEE Advanced. Well, I think, Stuti, there are inter-IIT events for every domain. You have cultural fest, you have technical fest, you have sports fest. Very recently, they started with the literary fest. So, I think there are fests, inter-IIT fests for all different events.
Yes, Neha, to answer your question, if there is an educational tour arranged, then everybody is allowed, actually eligible to go. Oh, okay. For the students, yes, the BTEC students are encouraged to have their startup. There is a sale in IIT Roorkee by DST called Tides. They help in setting up all the startups, incubate all the startups for a certain amount of time with certain facilities that they provide also. But the student has to come up with a idea, a business, proper business idea, and if possible with a product idea, so that the incubation center can actually go thoroughly through it. They have their committees. They generally set up a committee for its examination, and then once they are satisfied, then they allow the startup to start with.
Janavi, we are answering queries related to the general supernumerary seats rules and the admission procedure. But in specific, if you are asking about hostels and the culture at IIT, then we are more equipped with answers related to IIT Roorkee.
Akansha, that way I must say that it's thoroughly transparent, 100% transparent over here at IIT Roorkee. Of course, you get to see our marked, graded answer scripts after the exam. Generally, there are timelines associated with that also, that by what time you were able to see it. And if you have any further query, that is also addressed by the instructor of the course. and then your grade point is awarded.
Yeah, yes, outside the campus also there are some good music teachers, instrumentalists and as well as vocalists, though not many as you would find in very big cities because Roorkee is a relatively small town. But yes, we do have instructors. Khushbu, we are not too sure about how the filling up of seats in one category by the candidates from other category happens. For that, maybe you can write to the chairman JEE.
Ramya, yes, it is open to all the branches.
Neha, yes, it is dependent on CGPA and in fact it is a very competitive one. So the student that get a chance has to have a really very good CGPA. Stuti, to answer your question, IIT Roorkee campus, if we are talking about, is not very large as compared to say IIT Bombay, Madras, Kharagpur or even Kanpur also. So over here the students are able to, and we have a very nice campus over here, very nice roads with all the greenery. So the students prefer to move on their own bicycles. And you have the battery operated rickshaws also in case you need to go somewhere fast really quick. But the other IITs also generally the students do use bicycles at the backs.
Couple of other IITs also have public transport system. For example, if you go to IIT Madras, you will find the public bus, which is the institute bus, which keeps flying on a defined route. And so different IITs have different policies. Here, since IIT Roorkee campus is a very compact one, so we have the policy of non-motorized transport, which is bicycles for students. Yeah, I think there is no specific program, for example, as you are asking, sustainable engineering. But as far as sustainable sustainability is concerned, I think every department now has research happening in this domain, because that is something which is quite a focus across the world. So if you come and join, I think you will have ample of opportunities to join one of the projects in any of the branches, depending upon your choice.
I think to seek opportunities outside campus, IIT Roorkee will not be able to provide a platform for you. You have to seek your own platform for that purpose.
Thank you.
देर के लिए अपना इंटरनेट ऑफ कर देंगे।
दीपक, जी आप कौन हैं?
Okay. Yeah.
How are the international tariffs for summer interruptions?
Okay. Jahanvi, how are the international? Okay, Jahanvi, the international tie-ups for summer internships are, I wouldn't say that there are many tie-ups for summer internship, but by the virtue of being at IIT, the students, if you have good CGPA, if you perform good, if you have a good portfolio, you get very good opportunities for summer internship.
IDD,
integrated dual degree.
Yeah, here I think you're talking about IDD, integrated dual degree, right? So there are IDD available in some branches in IIT Roorkee as well as in other IITs. So it's a dual degree program. Basically, you go out with a BTech and an integrated MTech degree, PG degree. So that's what it is. So it has a thorough research program included in it, almost similar to a kind of a thesis work that you do in a master's program.
Well, Nandini, I think IIT Roorkee, if you have read a little bit about IIT Roorkee, you must be knowing that IIT Roorkee is the oldest institute, engineering institute of the country. It was set up in 1847, and the alumnus from IIT Roorkee are at the most prestigious positions currently, whether you name it railways and especially in the government departments, because that has been, IIT Roorkee has always promoted the national flavor, nationalist flavor. And that is why you would see our alumnus in all the good, big, reputed places. People who have won Padma Shri and Padma Vibhushan as well. And very, very strong network of alumni is there at IIT Roorkee. So I think if you join, you will be inheriting a comrade and you will be taking that further. So be assured that you are going to join a very big league of alumni.
I think that's the answer to the earlier question. It was about IT and
Akanksha, not just in CS, but in all branches, the syllabus is revised every couple of years to incorporate, to accommodate the new subjects, the new fields which are coming in. And if you look at the CS department at IIT Roorkee, you would find a number of faculty members conducting their research, and the research is reflected in the teaching as well. No, Kushi, I think the allocation of seat goes on till second or even third round at times. AK, I think the counseling is all online. You don't have to report to any particular IIT. If you still have some query, you can write to the chairman JEE regarding that. But as far as I know, it is all online. No, Stuti, usually the classes for first years, they start a week late. The all other students and their classes, they resume, they commence by the date that madam has just told, say around 16th or 17th of July. First year, since the entire first year comes together, so you will not be missing any classes.
Your classes will begin only from 25th or whatever date is given to you.
Kushi, it seems the allocation process is thoroughly online. So probably you don't need to visit any IIT at any point of time. But if you want further information, you should actually look into the JOSA website or write to the chairman JEE regarding this.
How do we compare the bank value of UIIT versus the
old IIT? I don't think we should comment on it. There is nothing like such. Nandini. Ramya, I think you were probably mixing up. We didn't tell about the vacancies in the exchange program. That was about the change of branch. That depends on the vacancies. The exchange program depends on the availability of internship positions in the institute that you wish to go, and your CGPA and your interest in the program, the way it is judged that if you are suitable and you are given the offer for the exchange studentship.
Okay, so the vacancies are often created for many reasons. One, sometimes a student takes up a seat in a particular branch in an IIT, but he gets some other branch in some other college or some other program altogether. So he may leave the course and go. That's one, for personal choice, for admission purpose, or maybe there are some personal reasons for people for which they may leave. That is how one set of vacancies is created. That's the most common how vacancies are created. In I think that's the main reason.
What will happen?
Mock allotment. That will be a tentative allotment
of seats.
Of seats.
For seat. No, Vishakha. There is no separate rank list for girls. Is it incorporated? I answered that query, Grishma. We revise our syllabus quite often, and more newer concepts are brought into the syllabus of the existing courses. So, though it doesn't happen immediately, it may take a little time, but it will happen. It happens. No more questions? Deepak, mute kar dete hain thodi der ke liye. क्वेश्चन
कुछ हाँ ये वाला था
ओके Precisely, Lakshita, that is what we have been trying to tell all the students, that it is not that a certain branch has suddenly become irrelevant or there is no scope. There is scope, and in current times there is a lot of interdisciplinarity which is coming into teaching as well as research. So it is not that just a chemical engineering graduate is going to do only chemical engineering throughout his life. You may go on to do some more course, something in computing, something in, you know, some other field, and then diversify. So that is what is showing in the cutoff of chemical at IIT Bombay. Okay. Vishakha, please visit the JOSA website to see what was the previous year's rank cutoff. I think you will get a relatively better idea of how the ranks branches were allocated based upon the rank.
Nandini, to take your question, every branch including metallurgy and material science has a lot of scope in job prospect, in higher studies and other things. So I think every branch has its own scope and prospect.
How far is the IIT campus from the nearest railway station or bus station?
Stuti, if you're talking about the Roorkee campus, it's just adjacent to the bus station and is very nearby, I think 2.5 to 3 kilometers
from
the railway station.
4.5 kilometers from the railway station.
And you have enough transport available. So
I think Stuti and all other candidates who are hearing us, probably IIT Roorkee is one campus which is closest to different modes of transport. Railway station, bus stand. If you go to bigger cities, probably you will be traveling 25 to 30, 40 kilometers at times to reach your IIT campuses. But IIT Roorkee is at max 4 kilometers. Khushi, you can write you can clear your doubts by sending us an email at the jeew.helpdesk@iitr.ac.in. We would try our level best to revert back and solve your queries. I think Srushti is from the southern states and she can help you.
Can you repeat? Students come from all parts of the country here, and it's a good platform to exchange ideas and discuss about the various cultures across India. Don't look at it as a difference. In fact, it is a place where you can experience and evolve culturally as a human being.
Yes, Ramya, irrespective of the IIT or the branch, the supernumerary seats are going to be available.
Neha, is there reservation
as per
government, even in the
17%
seats? Is there reservation as per
government? No. No, Neha, as per in the supernumerary seats, as far as I know, there is no reservation as per government orders. Anurag, we do not have the clear list of how many female students have cleared under 5000 rank.
In case we get that statistics, we get that data, we will share on the website itself. Here, I think the scope in civil engineering is quite wide and vast. And I say it repeatedly that because of the interdisciplinarity that has entered in every stream today, it is not branch specific. You are looking at not just civil engineering, but there are many other branches which open up once you enter a particular branch of engineering. Yes, irrespective of how you have entered, the branch change option is available for all the students equally. No, Lakshita, as far as I know, when you enter for any course here, the first year is common and it starts from the subjects which you have already studied, and it gradually takes you on to study those specific subjects which are related to that particular branch. So it is not that abruptly you will be taught some things, you are gradually taken into that course. Lakshita, in today's times, there is nothing that is difficult for girls. Probably there was a time when, because of the socio-cultural setup of our, society, certain branches were considered so. But in today's times, there is no limitation. Girls are going everywhere. They are conquering, different fields. So there is no limitation of such sorts. No, Suti, I don't think there are any prerequisites for taking admission in any of the branches. You can take up any branch, and the course and the structure, the syllabus, is absolutely self-sufficient to start you from a level which you have left in the school in your 11th and 12th, and gradually take you on to help you become a successful professional, both as far as your technical knowledge is concerned and also overall personality development.
Yeah. Are there internship programs for first year itself?
They start from second year.
Yeah, here officially as part of the curriculum, you are required to start after second year, completing second year. But if you are keen on doing internship, you can look at the options on your own, and you can explore different companies. Sorry, can you repeat?
Yes, you have this program stuff, you have the minors and the electives.
Yeah. Nandini, as far as the official curriculum is concerned, yes, there are certain opportunities. For example, the minor program. But beyond that, IITs are a place where you meet up people from different branches, different disciplines, and that is what helps you grow. So IITs are so successful because you have a very good peer around you. Yes, you can join projects with the faculty members if you are interested.
I think mute